Hi everyone, my name is Sienna. In this video, I'm going to teach about how to place an object on the placement indicator that will be in the middle of the screen. So instead of placing the object on the touch position, we will place it on this indicator. This tarial is using ARFoundation 5 in Unity 2023. The source code and all the files can be downloaded in my Patreon, and it's available for everyone. First, make sure that you already have all the projects set up, such as the package manager and the player setting. I'll be using the new input system. Make sure you have installed the new input system and set the active input handling in player settings to both. If you don't have the project set up yet, check my basic setup video. Make sure you already have SR origin and AR session in your scene. And then in SR origin, add component AR plan manager. And then add component AR request manager. Because we already have the placement indicator, we don't need to see the plan being visualized. So we don't need to add the plan prefab. Create a new script and let's call it place on indicator. Let's create the placement indicator. So create empty game object and let's name it as placement indicator. Make sure the position and rotation is set to 0. And then create a plan game object. Import the indicator image into Unity. And let's create a new material. Set the shader to unlit transparent. Put the image as the texture. Set the material to the indicator plane. Then change the scale of the indicator to fit with the prefab that will be spawned. Let's make it smaller. Open the place on indicator script. And then add using Unity engine.sr.ar foundation. And add using Unity engine. SR.AR subsystems. And then let's remove all this. Add a game object called flash prefab. And then let's serialize this game object. Flash prefab is the prefab that will be spawned. And then add a game object called spawn object to store the instantiated flash prefab. And then we will need AR cache manager. And let's call it AR cache manager. And then add a list of AR request hits. And let's call it as hits. And then in await, we need to get component of this AR request manager. To make sure that the AR request manager will be in the game object, we can add require component type of AR request manager. And then we will also need the placement indicator itself. Add a game object called placement indicator and serialize this. We will hide the placement indicator at the beginning of the scene. And then in update, we check if the AR cache manager hit any trackables. So instead of the touch position, we want to place the placement indicator on the middle of the screen. So the x-axis will be the width of the screen and the y-axis is the height of the screen. Go back to the script and then let's create a new vector 2 for the middle of the screen. It's the screen width divided by 2 and the screen height divided by 2. And then for the hit result, we already created the list of the AR cache hit. And for the trackable type, let's just use plane within polygon. Let's get the first hit. So the first hit will be the closest because trackcast hits are sorted by distance. And then change the placement indicator position and rotation to the hit post position and rotation. And if the placement indicator is not active, we make the set active to true. The reason why we didn't just set the screen middle as a variable in the await Yes, because if the user changes the orientation of the screen to landscape or portrait while in the middle of using the application, it will still be fine. And then let's add a new function and call it place object. So if the placement indicator is not active, we stop the rest of the function. And then we check if the spawn object is null. And then we instantiate the place prefab on the placement indicator position and rotation. And if the spawn object is not null, we just change the spawn object position and rotation. You can call this function depending on how you want the user to be able to place the object. For example, you want to call this function anytime the user taps on the screen. Let's add using Unity Engine, the input system. And then let's add a new variable for input action. And let's call it task input. Serialize this variable. And then in await, we check if the task input is being performed. We will call the place object function. Then enable and disable the task input. Save the script and go back to Unity. And in XR origin, add the place on indicator script and add the placement indicator and also the place prefab. And for the task input, add a new binding. And then let's set the path to pointer press. And then if you click play, and then if you look around, you see that the placement indicator will be in the middle of the screen. When there is no detected plane in the middle of the screen, maybe because the floor is difficult to be detected, the indicator will stop in the last position when it's detected. And then if you click anywhere on the screen, it will spawn the place prefab on the placement indicator. You can also hide the placement indicator if there is no trackable in the middle of the screen. In update, add else, and then hide the placement indicator. You see that if there is no trackable in the middle of the screen, the placement indicator will disappear. So if there is no trackable, even if you tap on the screen, there is no place prefab being spawned. We can also place multiple objects instead of just one. You can just delete this part and just keep instantiating it. Then now you can instantiate multiple place prefab. We can also change instead of the user tapping on the screen, we want to place the object on button press. Let's create a button. Let's change the text to place. Make the place object function as public. Don't forget to remove everything related to the task input. And then in the button, we add XR origin to unclick. Then we call the place object. And then if you press play and press the place button, it will spawn the object. And that's all for this video. Please subscribe to my channel and check out my Patreon. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to ask in the comment below. Thank you for watching.